today's video, we want to cover a situation that I think everyone is aware of, which is what to do when alarms appear during a resuscitation. Today, we cover specifically the corpuls CPR alarms.
As a general rule, if an alarm or problem occurs that cannot be resolved immediately, switch to manual compressions right away.
The corpuls CPR signals an alarm in three different ways. First, I have an acoustic warning tone. Second, I can find a symbol on the display which can tell me the possible cause. And third, the LED lights up the different colours. At first, there would be a yellow alarm. This indicates to me that I have a call to action that needs to be worked on as quickly as possible before the LED changes to a red alarm, meaning that I really need to do something now. Third would be turquoise. However, this is rather irrelevant during use as it is usually to do with the memory card and does not directly affect the therapy. I would just look into that after the mission. Alarms in the context of resuscitation often occur in connection with the stamp position control. Andy, would you like to briefly explain what the stamp position control actually does?
Yes, with ongoing chest compressions, the patient's chest will increasingly sink. The corpuls CPR recognizes when this happens and adjusts for it. But if a certain range is left, we as the user have to adjust it manually, and the device indicates this acoustically and visually, and we need to react to this yellow alarm. Now we have the yellow compensation range has been exceeded alarm, so then I would adjust it manually. Verena, stop the therapy.
Okay.
I'll open and adjust it, close it, and on green it carries on again. This can also be integrated into a ventilation break really well.
In this situation, the yellow alarm has now been resolved by readjusting the arm. Of course, it could also be that we have to consider the stamp needs changing. If we started with the short stamp and the thorax height is simply no longer sufficient for it, we need to switch to a long one. Another possible alarm occurs when the therapy is interrupted. If I stop the therapy while the therapy is running, the device will alert me with a yellow alarm, indicating that I should continue the therapy. Here you can see how it escalates. Because if I don't do anything at this point, the red alarm goes off after 8 seconds, alerting that I've interrupted the therapy for so long, and I should definitely continue it now. I can, however, acknowledge this alarm when, for example, I consciously decided to interrupt the therapy at this point.
If the chest compression depth set on the corpuls CPR cannot be reached, the device shows this parameter on the display in red. Repositioning would be necessary here. If the compression depth still cannot be reached after repositioning and/or changing the stamp, the parameter remains red. What we have shown you here are the most common alarms and their possible solutions. However, we now want to show you what to do when an alarm occurs that cannot be solved immediately. During the course of the therapy, an alarm with a high need for action unexpectedly occurs. Okay, we have a red alarm, Verena. Please get ready for compressions. I'll swivel the device away and I can calmly see what the problem is while you continue manually. We want to give you two more practical tips to take with you. One is about the stamp. If it does not sit absolutely flat on the patient's thorax because the thorax may have sunk, it's not a problem as long as the chest compression point is correct. Then therapy with the corpuls CPR is possible.
Also, the battery can run out. Should this occur, or if the battery overheats, it is advisable to simply change the battery out for the spare. If I change the battery within 30 seconds, I don't have to start the device again. I can continue the therapy immediately using the previous settings. In summary, in this video, we have seen the different alarm priorities and how the stamp position control works. We've gone through the most common alarms and how to fix them. We also discussed what to do when a red alarm occurs that cannot be immediately identified, which is stopping mechanical CPR and transitioning to manual CPR. For further errors, as well as all other possible sources of errors, you can always check out the instruction for use. Otherwise, we hope that was very informative for you and that you were able to take a lot away with you for everyday practice. Until the next video.